Okay, so really quickly, I'd like to look at this function. I'd like to show that it satisfies the wave equation. I'm going to go through this rather quickly. So our concept is the wave equation itself. And that is, the second partial derivative of f with respect to x minus 1 over the wave speed squared times the second partial derivative of f with respect to t, the time, position time, is equal to 0. Okay? Very simple. This is sort of the inertial term. This term has to do with tension. This connects the wave to the rest of the wave. This is the dispersive term. This is the inertial term, and this keeps something oscillating at one point. Fairly simple. So all we want to do is to throw y, substitute it in here, and see if we get 0. That's all you do if you want to check if this function satisfies this differential equation. We just want to see if it satisfies the equation. Is it a solution? In general, when I answer a question like this, what I've tended to do is to break it up, right? So first try the x, then try the t, and then put them all together in one equation, right? So first I'll take the x derivatives, then I'll take the t derivatives, and then I'll put them all together in the wave equation and see if it comes out 0. And this is fairly simple, fairly straightforward. Let's see, d squared y dx squared is equal to what? Well, with d squared dx squared of this thing, which is a sine kx, wave number times x. So you always have to have a wave number times x in the sine, because otherwise it's not unitless. This guy has to be unitless in here. Cosine omega t, again, omega times t, unitless. Needs to be unitless in here. So you always need a frequency times the time. All right. Let's see, a comes out. And it turns out omega t has no explicit x dependence. This is a partial differential equation, so it has no explicit dependence on x. It comes out. Okay, and then we have our leftover d squared dx squared times this sine kx, or of this sine kx, excuse me. All right, so let's see what good things can we do. Well, we can just take the first of these derivatives. That's going to be k cosine kx, right? So we have a k cosine omega t, because the k is just a constant, so it'll come out, d dx cosine kx, all right? And then we just finish up. We do this last derivative. So that's minus k cosine, or minus k sine kx, right? So minus a k squared sine kx cosine omega t. You know, if you can look at this, you could also say it's minus k squared y, right? Which is perfectly fine. A lot of times you'll see that happen. You'll spend a lot of time looking at things like that in the future. This is actually very useful if you can do this. If you keep working on things a lot, then by shortening things down like this, you don't have to worry about it. You know, it just saves a lot of time writing and a lot of confusion, because there are fewer things to lose. May as well get in a good habit early. Otherwise, it takes longer to get rid of it. So then we want to take the temporal derivatives, right? So that's d squared y dt squared. All right. And we do the same fun thing, only with the t's. So a sine kx cosine omega t. A comes out, kx has no temporal dependence, so a sine kx ddt, square that, cosine omega t. Derivative of cosine omega t is minus omega sine omega t, so we have minus a omega sine kx ddt sine omega t. We take this derivative, that's omega cosine omega t, so we have minus a omega squared sine kx cosine omega t, which is equal to minus omega squared this time times y. Looks very, very nice. Something we can work with. And then we'll substitute into the wave equation. Okay, and when I substitute into the wave equation, let's see, that's d squared y dx squared minus 1 over v squared d squared y dt squared. Since I've done this already, I know that d squared y dx squared is just this minus k squared y. So that's minus k squared y minus 1 over v squared. And I also know this d squared y dt squared, d squared y dt squared is equal to minus omega squared y, minus omega squared y. Okay, so that's minus plus, blah, blah, blah. So we end up with minus k squared plus omega squared over v squared y. Oh, that doesn't look good, does it? That doesn't look like zero. Well, let's just remember what that V stands for. So V is equal to omega over K, right? That propagation speed is omega over K. And so if we've got this propagation speed being omega over K, then we can substitute that in here. And we have minus K squared plus omega squared over omega over k squared, which is equal to minus k squared plus k squared equals zero. And we've shown what we intended to show, which is that this function, a sine kx cosine omega t, when substituted into the wave equation, gives you zero, so it satisfies this relationship here, which is what makes it a wave in the first place. So, you know, we can do all the fireworks stuff because we win. We got to where we wanted to go. We showed that this is indeed a wave. All right. See you in class.